My notes. Let's see. Okay, it's officially 7 o'clock, so thank you for joining me. I'm going to go over a couple housekeeping notes. The projects that we're making tonight, there is an order and incentive. So if you want the kit to make the three projects we're making tonight, it requires a $50 order using the hostess code that's posted on my website today. It's embedded in that post three times. And you have until Monday night at midnight to place your order. If your order is $150 or more, don't use the hostess code. We're automatically sending the kits to everyone that places an order of $150 or more, or if you use the hostess code. Okay, housekeeping notes. I have to look at this. Oh, the door prize form is officially loaded there. All you do is just click on the word door prize form. You fill that out. We're sending two additional kits free to two people. I better write that down. Sometimes I give three. This month we're given two free kits for November. So fill out that door prize form. And don't forget to put your email address in there so that we can email you. I don't typically post those on my website, just because when we draw them, it's after the fact. And we found that it's better to email. The wish list is over there if you would like to print it. And I think that's it. Okay. So the three projects that we're making today, I always like to do a little explanation of how I chose the projects. I will admit that 2 months in a row now, I've been quite stressed out about choosing the projects. And I think the reason is because we're sending the kits after the fact. And so I don't know if I'm going to have 8 people do order or I'm going to have 50 people order. So I have to make sure that I can actually physically afford, or I can cut these kits and supply them to everyone and not break the bank. So it takes some thought. But I was able to do so. So these are the three projects. And I normally do a box, a bag, and a card for a workshop. But this time I thought that since it's November, but it's technically almost December, and it's all about gift giving right now and memory keeping. So I've got a little gift bag. And I was going to fill this up with tags, and we were going to make tags. But then I'm like, well, we could just pretend this thing is full of tags. There's a ton of tag ideas out there. Even in the holiday catalog, there's several of them. And I didn't want to copy anything. The door prize form is on today's post. If you scroll down in the blog post, you will see where it says what's going to be included tonight. And if you just click on the word door prize, it will take you to the form. Okay, so this is supposed to be a bag of tags, but there's no tags in there. And then this is a gift card holder, and the gift card just slides right inside there. There will be a combination of colors. This is the soft sky color, but there's also real red and other colors in there. So what I'll do is I'll try to make sure that the paper that we send in the kits will match the silver or the red taffeta ribbon, because I think that's really cute to have that little bow at the top. And then we're going to do a little Project Life page. This is the Hello December kit. It's in the holiday supplement. It's available while supplies last. My page is pretty simple, but you guys know that that's my style. And then here's the back side. I don't have any journaling on this. My writing's terrible, and I didn't decorate this yet. But when you're placing your cards in here and your pictures and stuff, be mindful of the back side. Because for this one, this is the other side of that. So it worked out fantastic that this was next. Anyway, okay, I'm going to look for questions really quick. Do you have any questions before I get started? Okay, I don't think so. If you have any trouble at all, like at some point tonight, the video will stall. And when that does, just refresh your screen and it will pick right back up. You might lose a couple seconds, but just hit refresh on your screen and you will get caught back up. We're going to start with the pretend bag of tags. Let me get my supplies. Okay, so I've got my little project supply sheet here. We're going to be using the star framelits, the 1-inch square punch. We're using the gold basic metal buttons. The stamp set is Holiday Invitation. I love, love, love that stamp set. I'm trying to make sure that I'm filming the actual desk and not my lap. I don't think I'm filming my lap. You guys would let me know if I was, right? Okay, so for the framelits, we're using number 3 and 4. Yeah, 3 and 4. Oh, you're sitting there with your chicken scratch mug. That's awesome. I almost had mine here, but since, you know, a few times ago, I actually flicked some paper into my coffee cup. I'm like, I don't want to mess up my Project Life page, so no coffee tonight. But I love hearing that. Okay, so I'm going to take all the supplies out. If you place your order, this is what's going to come in your kit. Everything's bagged and organized beautifully. I like doing kits. Okay, so we're going to open this up. And the bag looks better if you put something inside there. So what I did for this one is I put crinkle paper in there. But I didn't bring any crinkle paper over here, so we'll just pretend. And the ribbon, I cut 18 inches. I like to be... Okay, wait a second. Let me rewind here for a second. I forgot to push the flaps back. I think I interrupted in mid-sentence. I was trying to say that I like to be generous with the ribbon so that you don't have to struggle to tie it. There's someone from Tennessee. I hear it's been just as cold there as it has been here. Oh, I forgot to get my ribbon scissors. Hold on just a second. They weren't very far. I love this ribbon. I was going to use the sheer cherry cobbler ribbon, but I've already used it several times, so I'm like, let's change it up. And I will be honest and tell you, when I was creating this bag, I was going to use the decorative mask, and I was going to sponge on some stars all over the whole entire bag. I can't find the thing. I swear someone came in and stole it, but I say that all the time, and then I find it later, so... I know it's just buried somewhere. So you could decorate this bag a little bit more. Although I really do like it simple. I have a feeling that maybe if I had stamped it with the stars, I might not have liked it. I don't know. I don't know until I see it because I'm a visual person. Okay, so I got the ribbon on there. I'm a little wordy. Well, I'm always wordy. Maybe. I don't know. Am I? So now I'm going to stamp. I'm going to take the Early Espresso ink. And I don't want to stick my head in the camera. My hair is clean, but I didn't flat iron it. So it's kind of frizzy. Sorry. I almost laughed, and then I choked. So I'm going to take the 1-inch... square punch. Oh, Nova Scotia. That's awesome. Yes, I'm still selling the mugs. They're over... Sorry. They're on the Chick Shop. So if you go over to mychickenscratch.com blog and underneath the banner, click on Chick Shop and you go over there and I have coasters, the calendar file, the mugs, the keychain, oh, and some retired stamp sets. Yeah, I'm adding more and more, but I swear, it takes forever. Because you got to have a picture, you know. If I could just type the words, it'd be one thing. Okay, I got to stop talking for a second. What am I doing? Oh, I'm looking for dimensionals. So I'm going to put two dimensionals on here. And then I'm going to set it aside. And then we're going to cut out our... Ooh, I got to make room for the big shot. It seems a little cramped here. Maybe I said that last time, too. I'll put that up there. Okay, I'm getting the big shot. I think I'm going to have to do it sideways. In fact, I know I am because my laptop is right there. It's gonna hit it if I don't. Okay, so magnetic platform and a cutting pad. And then the cherry cobbler is going to be the that row. And then the little star is the under the tree specialty paper. Yeah. Row. Whoa, get over there. I kind of like this sideways thing. Oh, the screen keeps messing up. You know what? Sometimes it messes up when I make loud noises. So maybe when I put the big shot away, it'll be fine again. It doesn't like, yeah, it doesn't like loud noises. Let's see if it's better now. So I don't lose anything else in this room. I'm going to go ahead and put these in here. And if I was at a workshop, I was at someone's house, I would do that as well so that I could show them how to keep their stuff organized. Okay, got my bag here. And I need my dimensionals again. This would be really cute with some tags inside there. I think I'm going to make some to give. I say that, but... Oh, you know what? I can ship over there, but I asked that you pay for the shipping that exceeds what it would cost in the U.S. So what we do is if someone like in Canada or somewhere else places an order, we will send them an email and say, hey, this is the amount of what it's going to cost to ship. Some countries, the shipping's comparable, and then some are like, holy cow, not even affordable. But if you want to pay it, we'd be happy to, you know, to check that for you. So whatever you want, if you place the order, we'll send you an email and ask that you pay for the difference in shipping. Okay, so there's the little button. I added it with a glue dot. And then I was going to add this. I was going to punch a hole here and use the linen thread and tie it on. But then I'm like, well, if I do that, then when you go to open the bag... Anyway, I'm just going to attach it with a dimensional. So if you make it, you can... You can add it using linen thread. I think it would be really cute if you did so. Isn't that cute? I like it. Okay, so, oh, I think I folded this one down more. I did. Well, just fold it down one more time. So there's project one. Where to find Peachy Keen. I have no idea, Liz. It has a website? I'm confused. Have I done a video making something with the tins I sell? Yes. If you go to my blog and you type in the search box, tin or Altoid tin, you will see them. Okay, now we're going to make the gift card holder. I love this. I got to put it somewhere close where I can look at it while I'm working. Oh, so look, on my punch right here, I have the little soft sky ribbon. Because at first I was going to use soft sky. It looked pretty, but it was almost invisible. So I decided to use the silver. So we're using soft sky. Oh no, where's my project supply sheet? I got to go find it. A sponge dauber. Mingle All the Way stamp set. Here's the supplies. Rhinestones. Thinlet. Framelit. And the ribbon. I didn't cut the ribbon for the kit yet. Okay, somebody asked me how I got my project supply sheets typed with the item numbers. So I'm going to go ahead and show you that really quick. It's called a lane swerve, but I had more than one person ask me. Okay, so this is my iPad Air, first generation, not this year's. This one's good. I don't need a new one. And so on my iPad, I have my document. And so, what I do is, as I type it, I don't know if you can see that screen. Anyway, I type it in here. See, just, so I type it, and then I tell it to print, right here on print, and then I print it. So, yeah. So when I create a project, I just type it up in here and send it to my printer. Okay. Hopefully the person or the people that ask were watching. If not, it's recorded, so they'll be able to watch it later. Okay, so for the project that we're making, gift card holder. I got to get the big shot out again. I'll go through the supplies really quick, and then I'll get the big shot. So this piece of paper measures 6 by 7, and then the belly band measures 3/4 by 6.5, and then the kit's going to have a soft sky and whisper white that measure 3.5 by 3 to make this section here. I'm going to slide this over for a second, that way I can get the big shot. So, oh, you know what? Actually, let me go ahead and stamp this first. This is not very organized. Oh, well. Most of you guys already know me, so. I love Mingle All the Way. I've been afraid that people are going to get sick of me using it, but, you know, I only have another month that I can use it, so I'm going to keep using it. I love Soft Sky too. I actually like it better than Pool Party, believe it or not. Okay. Oh, I'm going to sponge the edges. Somebody the other day asked me how come I stopped sponging. I'm like, oh, I don't know. I think I forget sometimes. It is kind of therapeutic when you sponge though. Okay, now I'm going to set this aside, and this aside I'm going to get the big shot. I'll try not to ding it so that it doesn't mess up the sound or the video. So a magnetic platform, cutting pad, the DSP, and then I just got to make sure I position it on here. Let's see. Well, it looks like I cut it too short. I didn't. I just can't see it real well. When the magnetic doesn't work, flip it over. There we go. Now it's working. Sometimes it doesn't. That just means you need to flip it. Can the gift card holder fit in the cuddle bug? You know, I don't know. If you will send me an email, I would be happy to test it for you. Now I'm going to cut the soft sky piece real quick with the decorative label. I think the deco label framelits are on sale this week. I'm pretty sure because I remember saying that they were my favorite. One of my favorites. Oh, she says yes. That's awesome. Yay! I hear my husband's footsteps up there. Okay, now for the assembly. Okay, so to assemble this, all I do is just put a strip of adhesive on this one side and then fold it over just like that. And then that way your gift card slides right in. And then the belly band, again, this piece measures 3/4 by 6.5. And all I do is just fold it over. Don't make it too tight. And then just put a little adhesive. I would use a glue dot, actually. Just remember when you fold it over to not make it too tight because you want to be able to slide it on and off. And then I attach this piece. Well, wait a second. Let me add this one really quick. And I just put the dimensional right on the belly band. And then that way, when they slide the belly band off, this comes off and nothing gets destroyed. Okay, so we've got rhinestones and our ribbon. Where's my paper piercer? Here it is. Okay, so one there, and I only added two because that whole rule of thirds thing. So one, two, and then the ribbon will be the third embellishment. So you can add as many as you want, though. Yes, you guys get to see my lovely thumb where I chewed my fingernail off. I do that on occasion every now and then. I'm going tomorrow to get my nails painted. But tomorrow will be too late. I'm going to add it with a glue dot. Some of y'all probably didn't even notice, and now I've drawn your attention to it. I probably shouldn't have said a thing. Isn't that pretty? Okay, so there's project two. Okay, I'm going to look for questions really quick before I get to the next one. If you don't have a magnetic platform, oh yeah, it is a must have. Absolutely. Oh, I love the word window punch. Yes, it is still available. It's in the catalog. I love my rhinestones. Oh, but she's not in the U.S. Right, Liz? Yeah, she's not in the U.S. Okay, so our final project, I'm going to move this aside, is going to be the page. I saved this for last. Okay, so someone asked if all my projects were going to be Project Life today. I'm like, nope, 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 nope. But I did want to show you a couple of things. Every time I kind of sort of mention the word Project Life, I'm starting to get like a ton of people tell me what I should be doing or what I could do or anyway. But I'm not the kind of person that actually wants to be told. I like kind of figuring it out on my own. So I've been kind of playing around with everything. I've got my stuff all set up. I got my printer set up. This was like my first official like little page that I actually call it completely done, because for me, if I write on it, it is done. I don't like my writing, but I know I have to write. So anyway, that was last Christmas, and I love that picture because Dave and I went to Best Buy to get a last minute gift and Chase was working. I thought he looked so cute. I had to snap his picture. Anyway. So, I'm very proud of this page. And then I went digging through my old pictures today and found this picture of the kids. But, okay, so lane swerve there. So, I started kind of pulling my Hello December kit together. And some of these ideas, like the little stars on this one, we saw that idea at Founder Circle. So, I can't really take credit for it. But it's stinking cute. And I just inserted the picture of Elvis there because one of the things I realize is when your kids are 21 and or 20 and 21, there's a whole period where they don't let you take their picture. So I have tons of pictures of them when they were little. But the last 5 years, not very many. So I'm going to start getting better about that. I hope they'll let me. But anyway, so you might see some Elvis pictures or a lot of Bella pictures. I'm not real sure what I'll be scrapbooking at this point, but it'll be a hodgepodge of stuff. And here is another page, and I think I showed this on a previous video, but I just wanted to show you guys really quick. I put these in here because that's where I'd put the picture. So this is journaling. This is decoration. These two are pictures. They're all color coordinated. Anyway. Okay, so now what people are going to get in their kit when they order. Where did I put that? Okay, so we're going to make a page. And I'm not real sure which color because I can't remember what kit. Here they are. Whew, I knew I did some. I knew I had it. Okay, I'm going to look for questions really quick. Oh, it froze. Sorry about that, guys. It was maybe it was when I was rattling. Oh. No, my handwriting is seriously chicken scratch. You have no idea how long that took me. I actually had to write it out on paper a couple times to get it adequately spaced. I have tried to find an app where I can print the journaling. And when I thought I had it figured out, it turns out I didn't. I was using the I use, what's the name of the, I can't remember the name of the apps right this minute. It's too late for me. My brain is froze. Well, I could look right here on my handy dandy phone, couldn't I? I think it's called PicFrame, right? Yeah. So I use PicFrame to print all the pictures. But when I went to do the words, I used the Project Life app. And for whatever reason, it is cutting off the border when I use the Project Life app. So I'm sure I need to just tweak something, I think. Look at Bella's face with the snow. I'm sad it was a blurry picture. But look, this is a print test. And it, again, it cut off that border. So I'll research it and try to figure out what I did wrong. But anyhow, okay, so to the kit. Let me show you what each person's going to get. Here's the kit we're going to make tonight. So if the card collection, everyone's going to get one of the December cards. So you're going to get one of these. And then each person's going to get an embellishment and a snowflake or a star and a number. So like this kit has 8. And then you're going to get one additional card. And then you're going to get a journaling card and then a solid piece. So if I give you olive, I'm going to give you a coordinating olive piece of cardstock. If I give you Lost Lagoon, you're going to get the Lost Lagoon journaling or card, whatever it's called. Can't remember right this second. And then that's another olive one. And then this is what the cherry cobbler one would look like. Yeah, if you get the cherry cobbler one. So it's going to have, so the olive and the Lost Lagoon will have silver and the cherry will have the red. Okay, I think I'm rattling. But what I did to do those was I just cut these in strips using my trimmer, and then I just start cutting them. That way I can slide them in to the pages. Oh, and you'll get a page also. Okay, we're going to make this page real quick. It's really easy. I'm not going to do the journaling either because that would require too much concentration. So we're going to be using the Cherry Cobbler. And the stamp set is December Wonder. I actually do really like this. I used the Christmas Cheer on something. And I used Hello Mary. And of course this one. I wonder what I used that Christmas Cheer on. It was cute, whatever it was. I'll have to find it. Okay, so for this, all I'm going to do is take my Cherry Cobbler and I don't know why I get scared about stamping on these things. They give you a ton of them in the package. So if you were to mess up one, it's not like it's the end of the world. That's that whole hoarding thing. So then I'm just stamping around. And then we're going to take the number 6 here. That is a 6, right? Who knows? It could be a 6 or a 9. I'm not real sure. I might need my paper piercer to make sure that I don't. I don't know. What do y'all think? Is that a 6 or a 9? I'm going to say it's a 6. And you could put it right here. Like, I went back and forth. The good thing about these things is that you can reposition them. So, I removed mine a couple different times. And then I'm just going to take, wait, wrong piece. Let's go ahead and slide this thing into the pocket. And look, I'm going to take that thing out because I'm not going to do the journaling. And slide this up here. But I would add, so journal, Then you're going to add your little sticker here and your little Dumaflatchy there. So we'll pretend that that's what I did. And then slide the picture in. Voila. Now, what I did on this picture is I trimmed it so that it could have the frame around it. You know, the cherry cobbler. And I didn't do that on this because this is just a sample for you guys. Look at my kids, though. Aren't they so cute? Okay. They still are. They're just older. Okay. Oh, that's right. She's drawing for rhinestones. I forgot about that. Oh, look. Ho, ho, ho. You know what? Actually, I want to change this up, though. Look. Ho, ho, ho looks better over here. Doesn't it? Okay, I'm going to look for some questions. Is the project app part of... No, it is not part of my digital studio. What paper am I using? Do you mean the cards in here? Connie, which paper are you asking about? Like the Hello December. Well, let me get all those cards. So if you order the Hello December, I guess maybe I could show you guys this. I don't know why I'm like keeping it a secret. I think because I don't have very much. Like compared to a lot of other people, mine is a little, it's a little lacking. It's not full. So I have, I'm going to do a Project Life online workshop. So I'll show all this. I'm going to label this with my P-Touch. I just haven't had a chance. But anyway, so I have all my cards organized by the pack they're in, and then the larger ones are over here on the right. So that's how I was able to just pull this right out. Oh, and remember when I said chicken scratch for handwriting? You have to admit that's kind of hard to read Hello December. Anyway, so I'm like seriously getting obsessed about it, but I have a lot to get caught up on because I haven't really printed very many digital photos. That's why I broke out that Canon selfie. Yeah, I think I stopped scrapbooking when the digital cameras became popular because it was like, well, they're all stored on your camera and your computer. But we're going to change that. Okay, so what I was going to say is these are all the cards that you get in the Hello December card collection. And I have a video that I did on everything that came in the kit, because there's a ton of other things too. This isn't, there's the accessory kit and all that. So Connie, if you were asking about these cards, they came from the Hello December Project Life kit. You don't have to really think about it. I mean, not really. Yeah, it's not a lot of thought. You just slide in the pocket. And that's the other thing too. Like, there are some people are going over the top, embellishing their pages and adding all sorts of things. And if that is what they enjoy, good for them. Yay. For me, it's simple, quick, get her done. 24. It's done. I like it though. It's so fast. No, I don't only buy Stampin' Up. I could pretend and say that I do, but no, I buy everything. What I do is I buy like what strikes my fancy. So I look at my pictures and I determine like what colors are in my pictures. And so if I see a kit somewhere else that matches my pictures, I buy it. I just don't put it out here and show everybody. I know, I'm scared too, because I was so obsessed with it for years. I did 17 albums in less than 5 years. And I would like to really go back and redo, because like this picture here, the album that has this picture, oh my gosh, it looks like somebody threw up on it. I mean, it's got stickers everywhere. But you know, that was the time. I'm not going to touch it. I'd like to go back and re-scrapbook all those years. I'm not going to, because we have a good laugh about it now. I got to show y'all a picture. I have it right here. Look, this is of my kids. This was in 1999, either 98 or 99. They were sitting on the bed looking at one of their scrapbooks. They used to love looking at their pages that I made for them. Okay, I'm going to look for questions. Let's see. Oh, yeah. We have a ton of Project Life stuff. We have it in our holiday catalog. We have it in our holiday supplement. And then we have it in our main catalog. So we have quite a bit to choose from. And everything that I've shown you is from Stampin' Up! Only. The stuff that I have that is not carried by Stampin' Up!, it's hidden on the other side of the room. Like, it's not even in my organizer because I want to make sure that the stuff I demonstrate is just Stampin' Up. Thank you. No re-scrapbooking. I did that once before. I redid one album years ago. I think it was maybe Brooke's baby album. Or maybe my wedding album. I'm not sure. And I'd love to redo that wedding album again. But I'm not going to do it. Yeah, don't you love this? Oh, I love... They were so photogenic back then. They didn't make crazy faces. I can't believe I had a shirt for my daughter with her name on it. That's so funny. Okay. You stopped scrapping because it got... Oh, I know. Lord, it was like a competition of whose page could be the most beautiful. let's see. I'm looking for questions now. I hate to touch this chat box because sometimes when I touch it, it gets all wonky. Okay, so if you guys ask me a question, please, and I didn't answer you, oh, I got my organizer from Close to My Heart. Truth be told, you know, I bought an organizer from IKEA. And when I got the thing in fact, I'll show it to you. So here's the thing I have from IKEA, and the problem is that when you add, I can move these, it don't fit. The cards, they fit up here at the top, but this wonky thing gets smaller at the bottom, and if you have this whole entire thing, I mean, yeah, you have to put them at an angle to make them all fit. I'm not about that. I don't want to damage it. It's too expensive to... Yeah, so, no, it don't work. I know some people use this system, but I'm going to use it for all the embellishments. So, these are all the little doodads. This is all the washi tape embellishments. And these are extra... accessory kits. Oh, you missed the organizer? I'll show you the organizer. Here it is. So it has a lid. It fits right on top of my cart. And so I have, I'm going to do a Project Life workshop. So I have all the cards in chronological order. So like this is the Everyday Adventure. And then these are the Happiness Is. Some people organize their cards by color. I'm not, because if I'm going to teach Project Life, I have to be able to tell you like that this card right here came from the seasonal snapshot, and I have to be able to tell you that this one came from the playground one. So I have mine organized by which card collection they came from. So here's the little printer that I showed yesterday. I used the Canon Selfie, and it's what I use to print quite a few pictures. And I can't believe the quality. I mean, like, look at this thing. If you just ignore the fact that that the writing went off the page, but if you look at the actual picture that it printed, and even like the picture of David and I, like the color is spot on. It's crazy. I printed this one too. Yeah, so I use this one. I will tell you that I know some people, if you have a Walgreens within driving distance of you, you can send them right over and then go pick them up in an hour. I got the Canon Selfie from Amazon. I think it's like 80 bucks. And I showed a video yesterday of how to set it up, how to load your paper, how to put the ink in. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I can't believe I waited like 3 months to turn the thing on. I'm slapping myself, but I had a lot going on. So that's, in my defense, I was working on the retreat. The printer, I believe it was $87 or $89. And when you run out of ink, when you run out of paper, you run out of ink. Like when you replace the ink cartridge, you also replace the paper. So there's no thinking about it. It's awesome. You know, I don't know about the pictures, Monica, as far as over time. Who knows? I know I've been scrapbooking now for, what is it? It'll be 1996. So 18 years, yeah, I don't know. No, the selfie goes right directly from my phone. So I showed a video yesterday on how to use it. It's wireless, so I just, this picture here even, is all I did. Where's the one? No, the Elvis picture. Where's Elvis? Let me find Elvis. This is so funny. So I took a picture of a picture and then I printed it on, you know, from my iPhone, because I took the picture of Elvis with my iPhone, a picture of a picture, and then I printed it and it looks beautiful. It's so crazy. yeah, I printed it right from my iPhone. Oh, you ordered a selfie. You know what, Jody? You'll be thanking me though. Because I don't, like, if I didn't like it, I wouldn't have shown a video. Like, I showed a video because I knew that you would love it, just like I do. And you can use it with your computer also, but you want to download the PicFrames app. Am I cooking for Thanksgiving? Yeah. Well, David's actually going to smoke the turkey on the smoker, so yeehaw. But I always make gumbo after Thanksgiving with a leftover turkey. So, yeah, he'll cook the bird and I'll cook the rest. But my sister's coming, so I'm going to make her fix something. Is having that printer more convenient? Well, yeah, because I can print on the fly. Like, if it strikes my fancy, I can just print right then and there. Whereas, Yeah, the other way you have to think about it. You have to, and you don't want to just print one picture. It's like, oh, if you're going to print one, you better print 20 or 30. And then you got to drive there. And yeah, I like having the printer here in my house. Yeah, you can take it and print it right out, right then and there. And the way I figure is it's better that it's printed and in a little page than just sitting on my computer that no one is ever gonna see except for me. Oh, the selfie is this printer. The Canon selfie. They have, it's the CP910. They have black and they have white. I have bought 3 different little portable printers like this. One was a PictureMate, and I don't remember the other 2 names. They've all ended up in the garbage. This is the first printer that I've actually had that I've printed multiples, and everything's working great. And I know other people that have it also. So, Susan, what it does is, or is it Susan or Margie? It's Margie, sorry. When you run out of ink, you run out of paper. It coincides with each other. So I get the 3-pack, and it comes with 3 ink cartridges and then 3 packs of paper. So when you run out of paper, you run out of ink. I love that there's no guessing. And yes, you can stick, there's a spot over. It's too bad I don't sell these darn things, right? You've got your USB and another adapter there, like a camera adapter. So if you didn't have an iPhone or the app, you could print it that way. But anyway, I have a video just, I posted it yesterday, and it's just for the Canon selfie. Because I was going to be showing this page tonight, so I wanted to be able to say, hey, I already have a video, you can go check it out. It's perfect. Yeah, I think I'm going to get my daughter one too. I think she would like it. 4x6 is the largest picture, because that's the size of the, yeah, that's the size of the paper. It comes with, like, you have to tear off a side on each side, but yeah. Oh, Chrissy, it cost, I think it was either $87 or $89. If you go to my blog post yesterday where I have the video on it, I actually have a link to the printer right in my blog post. It takes you right to Amazon to the exact printer. Oh, and yeah, and the containers from Close to My Heart. I don't remember how much it was, but I like it. It's the medium size one, too. Yeah, I don't know about the app. I know that Project Life is not on the Android yet, but maybe the PicFrame app is. I'm not sure. I know I've seen a couple Android people go and buy an iPad so that they could use. It does not come with a case. I think you could just put it like in a little camera bag, because this just comes out like that, and you just close it. So it's pretty portable. I've seen a lot of people carry them with them on trips and stuff. I'm thinking I could put it in my kid's small Nintendo bag. Okay, so I can't remember how I normally wrap these things up. I'm drawing a blank right this minute. We got to talking about the printer so much, I forgot what I was doing. Okay, so the projects that we made tonight were scrapbook page, or the pocket page. And then we made the bag of tags, the pretend bag of tags. Oh, it is on Android. That's good. Oh, the paper shredder. Let me get it, Susan. I should have stock in Amazon. It's called the Mini Paper Shredder. Again, I got it on Amazon. I just did a search for, and I love it. Now, somebody did order one, and theirs didn't work. I had to send it back, but I've used mine for several months now, and I only do one sheet, though. Don't do more. Just one. One sheet at a time. Oh, it's unavailable now? Ooh, sorry. Keep checking. That's crazy. I must have showed it one too many times. Oh, there's 100. I forgot to look and see how many there was on here. I think I had like 300 last time. Happy Thanksgiving. Oh, yeah. You know what? We all did the math before we ordered the selfie. We all determined that it was like the same cost as it is at the store. And you don't have to go anywhere. Okay, so if there's no more questions, I think I'm going to stop here. It's been an hour, and head over to my blog, and don't forget to fill out the door prize to win one of the kits. Thank you. Yeah, I got to set the date for December. It's going to be kind of crazy with the holidays. Ugh. Oh, I had 228 earlier. I think the paper shredder was like $17. It wasn't very expensive. What type of candy did I use in the project I sent out? Oh, which one? Thank you, Liz. Happy Thanksgiving. Robbie, which project are you asking about for the candy? Robbie, you're welcome to email me. Oh, okay. Good night, everybody. Happy Thanksgiving, and thank you.